news that's coming in right now. Karnataka Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy and rebel Congress MLA Ramalinga Reddy hold a meeting at an undisclosed location in Bengaluru. That's the latest information that's coming in. So Neha, of course, here on one hand, there is a breakfast meeting that has been called. But here, Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy and Ramalinga Reddy have, in fact, are meeting at an undisclosed location. So all efforts here on to pacify all those who are rebelling, Neha.
Absolutely, of course. The fact still remains, like I said a little while earlier, that Ramalinga Reddy, a heavyweight in the Congress party, losing a leader like him cannot really, you know, reflect very well on the Congress party. So clearly, of course, gone wrong to an extent where, if at all, the possibility of losing a senior leader like that of Ramalinga Reddy, then a lot of internal really thinking and inspection has to be done over here. We're also given to understand now that the Chief Minister, who came back just last evening, has been proactively going all out and trying to do his little bit to save his government. And whether, of course, we would see his resignation today, whether we'd see him stepping down and making way for the former Chief Minister, that's one option also that could possibly be. The pros and cons of that would also be weighed out today. That's what even the DCM, the Deputy Chief Minister, Dr. G. Parameshwara, did go ahead to tell us. So Ramalinga Reddy, of course, right now would play a key role over here, because many of the rebels, let's remember over here, have in fact resigned, keeping him in mind, keeping the fact that he was a senior leader. And maybe, of course, call it unfair if you will, but we did see a lot of protests that broke out over the past couple of months over Ramalinga Reddy being denied a ministerial berth, not being given a cabinet berth. But important here to remember also that yesterday, of course, when Ramalinga Reddy spoke to the media, he made it very clear that he's resigned from the post of his MLA and not from the party itself. So that's one thing, of course, that the coalition government has to their credit, that they would be able to, you know, possibly try and retain him. All efforts would be made, because he's clearly gone on to state that, yes, it's a resignation from my post of the MLA, but not from the party. So this means that at this point of time, at least, we're unsure about how many other of the ministers, or how many other ministers in terms of numbers, would be willing to step down, but someone will have to make way for him, considering that that is, of course, one of his demands. It has been there also for quite some time now. Warning signs have been ignored over here. We've been seeing how over the past couple of months, many demands have come up by people inside the Congress, by his supporters, by his, of course, followers as well. They've made it very clear that if at all Ramalinga Reddy is not given a plump post, is not given a ministerial post, then that could prove to be very costly for the party. And it seems like somewhere now that is finally coming to the fore, and options would have to be considered over here now.
Right. So basically what you're telling us, Neha, is that there was simmering discontent for a long time, and somebody